Amazing news, we can now install Google Assistant on the TicWatch Pro 5, and we can also customize the buttons to start it and even add more functionality to the buttons using Bubble Cloud. Please see the description of this video where I link to the instructions how to sideload Assistant Go version 2.8 from APK Mirror. Once you do that, Google Assistant will appear as Assistant Go on your watch. I moved it to my Google folder here in Bubble Cloud Launcher. Bubble Cloud Launcher has this voice assistant icon. If you have Google Assistant installed, it will give you the option to assign Assistant Go to it. More importantly, we will want to assign Assistant to the long press of the crown. And this is done by going to the Google Assistant Go application, not the voice search, the Google Assistant Go application, and long press on its bubble, and under assign shortcut, choose long press button. So we choose this option. We will have to exit back to the launcher. And from now on, if we long press the main button, it will start Google Assistant. What time is it?
It's 5:08 p.m.
And it works like charm. As an added advantage, we can also assign a second long press action to this button. We can do it either by selecting the application that we want to assign to it. So for example, if I wanted this 3D printing Octo app to be assigned to the second press of that button, I could just select two times long press the button and it will be assigned. So I press long press once and long press again, and this Octo app is started. Another way to assign these functions is in the Bubble Cloud settings, under shortcuts, we see long press and press again. Long press is assigned to the assistant and press again to Octo app. And there are other options that we could assign to the second press of this button. We could assign the doctor's timer built into Bubble Cloud. So now, if we long press twice, we will get this ambient mode with the second hand. We will want to give even more permission to Google Assistant Go. So I long press on the Assistant Go icon, go down to the bottom and go to app info. And here we can give more permissions. So under permissions, we can give Google permission to access our contacts, our phone, SMS. And we don't want permissions to be removed. We can also go to advanced, and we can also give permission to modify system settings. So we will be able to ask it to change screen brightness and things like that. Under Bubble Cloud settings, shortcuts, we can also customize the secondary button press. We can select any action for it. For example, I can assign the flashlight to it. The first time I press this custom button, it's going to prompt me whether I want to still use recents or assign Bubble Cloud to this button. I will want to assign Bubble Cloud to it because in Bubble Cloud I will be able to customize how it works. So we just set it to always. If I just press that button, we get the flashlight. We can also assign a secondary function to this button using Bubble Cloud. It's going to happen when we press it twice. If you quickly double press it, it will bring up Google Pay. But we can take any other app, for example, Fat Finger Calculator, and assign that to double pressing the secondary button. So now double pressing will bring up Fat Finger Calculator. Single pressing takes us to flashlight. Pressing it twice takes us to the calculator. 2 plus 2 is 4.
The TicWatch Pro 5 is currently the best watch we can get on Wear OS in terms of battery life, performance, screen tech, RAM and storage size. Nothing comes close. Software is another matter. Google disappoints again, but all limitations introduced with Wear OS 3 can be overcome with bubble clouds. It restores button customizability, brings back wrist gestures, provides an alternative way for the missing notification preview complication, and we can still have Google Assistant on long pressing the main button.
Set volume to 100%. Call Budapest Bank home.
Calling Budapest Bank.
Ön az MKB és a korábbi Takarékbank Egyesült Telefonos Ügyfélszolgálatának telefonja.